Hi guys, Chuff here again, and just want to show you my Kharn that I've painted up recently. What I've done on this case, both heads are magnetised. The shoulder pads I haven't glued on at the moment, and the actual weapon goes in on the pin system that it comes with. The only thing I did was just drill it out a little bit more, make it a smoother hole, as it were, for either weapon system. And I've also magnetised and pinned in the clamshell for the base, and I'll go through it as we go. I've really enjoyed painting this model, I have to be honest. I use some of the new techniques I've been learning and trying to improve my skills with all the time. So let me just bring up the main body and we'll go through it a little bit. So. See if I can focus, there we go. So, quite nice, simple design. I quite like the arm, the bare arm. And part of the reason why I haven't glued the shoulder pad on, because you'll hide half of this. And ultimately, I'm going to have to admit this, he's going on the eBay. So, what I'm going to do is actually leave the shoulder pads off, and whoever bids and wins for it can either have them not glued on, or glue them on himself, or I'll do it before shipping. Whichever the person wants, but really this is just a play with model. I enjoyed painting all the different metallics on this, so kind of like a muted gold brass type colour, very gladiatorial on the studs, which I did on the shoulder pads, a little bit on the knees, bring that up actually, look at the screen, not look at the model. So done on the knees as well. Basically, I followed Forge World's way of painting up the Kharn as closely as I could. Basic weathering, don't want to go too much, otherwise you'll detract from the model itself. So that was the body, and then the two heads. There's crap. First head. This is the one that has caused a bit of controversy, because some people think he should have just a helmet on, some don't. So I quite like this head. I think it's a very detailed head. I think they're getting a little bit better, although I still think that the Rampages are the worst heads they've ever designed at Forge World. I quite like this. I might see if I can buy one separate for another model I have an idea for. So that's that one. And then this one, which is the helmeted head, I've gone and put a crest on it. Gives it such a different look, and I really like this. If I was to keep this, I'd probably glue this head on, use that one for another one, and I'd only put one shoulder pad on the model, but it's not up to me. So I'm just going to actually snap that in on the model. There we go. And then the two weapons. So you've got Kharn the Bloody when he's got the cleaver type thing, and I've done blood effects all over it, which is quite nice. And then he's got Gore Child, which I've done, and I've put some blood splatters coming off, thanks to my friend of mine who told me how to do this, War Master Painting. Cheers for that, Nathaniel. That's actually quite nice, and that would be the one I would put on. Then you've got the two shoulder pads, try and keep the detail on screen. So there you go, quite a muted gold. I didn't want too bright because they're not too bothered about how they look. And I would stick that on his left shoulder. So if I bring him in, I would just stick that there and I wouldn't put the other one on myself. And then the other one, which is just a studded, quite nice piece. So that's actually Kharn himself. And then you've got the obvious beautiful little diorama, which they did a dead Raven Guard on it. I went for a dead Ultramarine mainly because of Aaron Densky Bowden's book on Betrayer, where Angron goes against a load of Ultramarines and so does Kharn. So I thought this is more fitting for more of the time. And you can see what I've done. I actually painted all the flesh tones, all the bones and everything, and then went in to do the blood effects. And I really actually enjoyed painting up this base. Kept it simple, kept it so it doesn't totally detract from the model. So here, let me see, zoom out a little bit and bring it back into focus. So let's just actually build this up on camera a little bit, or try to anyway. I'm going to get it to spin. So there's that. And you've got to locate it. And where is it? Come on. There we go. I think that's correct. Then on this piece, it's magnetized, but I've got a little pin to help guide it. So you find the little hole, he says. There we go. And it goes down really well. And I would personally have stuck this on. In fact, I'll put a little bit of blue tack in there just to hold it so I can get it to spin and you guys can see what I'm on about, maybe. So the head, there we go. So let me take the bear one away, the other shoulder pad and the other weapon, and then I can just hit this and put it in the center. So there we go, that's my Kharn. I've really enjoyed painting this. I've tried quite a lot of new techniques out. I do quite like doing white armor, giving it this kind of muddy dirty look without going too much. It's very easy to go far with red, but you don't want to go too far. The ultramarine was quite easy to paint up. I used a technique that I got off a friend of mine who does some really nice ultramarines. That's Trevor Goddard. So basically, I mean, a lot of this is me practicing new techniques, brushwork, wet blending techniques with single brush, things like that. So yeah, I enjoyed doing this, but unfortunately I don't have the space for all the models I'd like to keep, so this one's going to go up on the eBay, and I'll try and put a link down below. So please comment, rate and subscribe guys, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Take care.